Hi guys, what is up? My name is Matthew and I am here at the Malacca International Motorsports Circuit, or MIMC for short. We're going to be sampling, well, it's currently out there, but we are sampling the all new Honda City, specifically the EHEV variant. So that is the latest and apparently most powerful Honda City ever introduced. So as we know it, only the range topping RS variant will get Honda Sensing, and it almost has the full suite of Honda Sensing system, guys. It's got adaptive cruise control, it's got lane departure warning, lane keeping assist, it also has AEB and a forward collision warning system. So it's pretty well kitted out. There's also Honda Lane Watch that's built into the underside of the side mirror housing. So it's pretty well equipped, and it is the most sophisticated B-segment sedan so far that has been introduced in the Malaysian market. So kudos to that. In terms of dimensions, the all-new City is also longer by 110mm, wider by 55mm, and lowered by 10mm. This will apparently give you a lower center of gravity, so expect the ride and handling characteristics to be slightly better. Okay, my turn now, so let's go for a drive. So what you just witnessed was a demonstration of adaptive cruise control, which I did not too long ago. I just stepped out of the driving experience. But there is no low speed follow, so it has almost all the safety systems that you expect a Honda Sensing system to have, except low speed follow, which means it will slow down the car for you, but only until a certain extent before you have to fully depress the brake pedal yourself. But considering all else that you get, I think the omission of low speed follow isn't such a bad thing. But Honda Malaysia has introduced Honda Sensing in a B-segment sedan in Malaysia is a first for the market, and I applaud that move because it shows that they are committed to the technology. And first things first, I realized that it works almost as well, almost as refined and polished as the Honda Sensing system in the Honda Civic and the Honda Accord. So in terms of refinement, as far as the technology goes, it's pretty good. So I think you guys can expect the same experience when you test drive this for yourself. But let's talk about how it drives. I know 253 Newton meters of torque is the headlining figure, and rightfully so, because it's like a bold claim made even bolder by their advertising. But that's besides the point. I just want to say that 253 Newton meters of torque on a straight line really beats out the Honda City iDCD. And some of the instructors did like a drag race of some sort, and immediately right off the bat, you could see that the CTRS pulled ahead and by a considerable margin. And back to my point, coming from the City iDCD, which I thought was a phenomenal hybrid car when it came out back in its time, felt a lot faster in the CTRS. But I feel like the torque really comes into play when you're charging into a corner hot and you brake late, and then you want to power out of a corner fast. That is where the instant torque delivery is going to give you a little bit of pickup speed, especially when you're powering out of corner. Compare this to the Vios and to the City iDCD. They were slightly slow when powering out from the corner, so it feels like there's a slight delay between your throttle input and the car reacting to it. But with the City eHRS, it just feels quicker. Not a whole lot different, if I were to be honest, compared to the iDCD, because like they all give you adequate acceleration under full pelt. But really, to get the full feel of the City RS, I really have to put it through its paces in real world use, because just testing it around the track, yeah, I mean, drag race and all that might be fun, but in the real world, no one's gonna use it like that. Now, just to quickly summarize the video with some quick info, Honda Malaysia has already begun assembling the 5th generation Honda City at its plant in Pegoh, Melaka. So the City benefits from foam injection for better NVH, and Honda Malaysia says that it's up to 33% quieter now compared to before. And it has also brought in 5 new fully imported robots for the welding process. And this helps create a more structurally rigid body compared to the older City. Now, the 1.5-litre engine actually functions as a power generator to charge the onboard battery, which is a 48-cell lithium-ion unit that is called the IPU, or Intelligent Power Unit, and it is locally assembled here by hand at a new facility in Honda, one of their plants in Melaka. That is great news because, you know, transfer of technology and all that good stuff. So some of us Malaysians benefit from Honda's latest hybrid system firsthand. So that's good news. Now, I know I'm not supposed to show you the interior of the Honda City, but they didn't specifically say that I cannot tell you, in brief, what it's like. So here's a quick 11-second pitch. It's neater, there's more than one color, although I cannot say what color. And the cabin looks a little bit more sophisticated because it's got like modern tech tinkeries, like a nicer push start button and a nicer instrument display that may or may not be digital. And they've got paddle shifters, which may work in the way you think or not. Yeah, that's technically not breaking NDA, right? So make of that what you will. In short, it's pretty nice. I also kind of like the main infotainment screen. I think they've done a pretty decent job here. So yeah, so there you have it, guys. I'm sorry if this video doesn't have much meat to go with your potatoes, but this is again a very quick, brief, whatever drive of the Honda City. Expect the car to be launched very soon, and expect a full test drive review of the car to come very, very soon. I really want to see how this guy performs against the older hybrid. But so far, if you are interested in this guy, well, let us know what you think of the car so far in the comment section below. This has been Matthew. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I will see you perhaps at the launch of the City. Till then, bye bye and take care of yourselves.